Greg, a lot's been written about ETFs in the current market environment. Mm-hmm. They're making up the preponderance of trading out mm-hmm. there. They're providing a ton of liquidity.
Yep.
Now, 90% of the trading that goes on with ETFs occurs in the secondary market.
That's
where
right.
just two investors are finding each other in the market, and they're setting the price.
Yep.
In the 10% of occasions where there's an AP involved, mm-hmm. why don't you describe that process? Because as a result, too, things like discounts come into play. And I think it would be helpful for our clients to understand that a little bit better.
Yeah, so what happens in a redemption scenario is an AP would be delivering ETF shares to Vanguard. Vanguard would, in essence, be delivering the underlying bonds of that ETF back to the AP.
And so the APs look at this basket of bonds, right?
That's correct.
They're not getting cash. They're getting a basket of bonds that they're going to have to sell.
That's correct.
A volatile environment, they're really not quite sure what they're going to be able to sell
it. And there's greater uncertainty around the pricing of those bonds. And so they're going to charge people basically some insurance for the cost that and the uncertainty around what's the price that they're going to receive in the marketplace when they have to go through and liquidate all those individual line items.
So when an investor sees a discount mm-hmm. on an ETF, they really should say that, hey, that's the price of liquidity. If I want out now, that's what I'm going to have to pay.
Yeah, and so that's something they absolutely have to build in, but they should also think if they don't need liquidity at that point in time, they're better off waiting, right? They're better off waiting. But if you need that liquidity, yeah. that's a price you have to pay.
Agreed.